Factor Trinomials, reverse FOIL. Recall that when we were FOILing, we took the first terms, should give us AC. Then we took the outside terms, in this case, which would give us AD. Then the inside terms. And then finally, we would do the last terms. So our first multiplies to the AC, and the last multiplies to the BD. Now, the outside and the inside add together to give us the middle term. And this would be these right here. And those were usually like terms. Sometimes this is going to take something that we call some trial and error. And so a lot of times this method is called a trial and error method. Now I have some hints, some major hints, written down here for you. I would recommend that you write them down because they're going to be really, really helpful in factoring. And after a while, you'll have them memorized, and so you'll be able to really be able to use them. So our first example here is 3x squared plus 11x plus 10. So we're going to start by putting two sets of parentheses. And we're going to start with the 3x squared. Now, 3 only has one way of multiplying to get 3, and that's 1 times 3. So we're going to put those in here. And there's only one way to get x squared, and that's going to be multiplying x times x. So we put those in. And then we go and we look at our last term, which is a 10. We have two choices there. I always recommend that you avoid 1 and 10 because those will give you some really big numbers. I mean, that's not to say that you will not use it, but most of the time we're going to use 2 and 5. So I'm just going to put those in. It doesn't really matter the order that I put them in. Okay, so now that we've put our factors into place, now we're going to get to where these hints up here are going to help us. This right here is a plus, and notice that it says if the last term is a plus, we're going to add our outside and inside. That means we're talking about this is our outside, here's the inside. We're going to add those. That's going to give me 15x plus 2x. Well, that gives me 17x. I have 11 here. So that means that I don't have this where I need it. So this is where your eraser is going to come in really handy. So I'm going to change the order of my 5 and my 2. So that would give me my outside now is 6x and my inside is a 5x. 6 and 5 add up to be 11x, which is just what I want. Here's a nice thing about the last sign being a positive, which is what we have here. Our signs will always be whatever our middle term is, and that means they're both going to be plus. I don't have to worry about where they're going to be or what they're going to be doing. It's always going to be whatever that middle term sign is. And so now I have this completely factored. I've done this is right here is my check. This helps me tell whether I've got the right answer or not. I already know that the last ones are right because I only use factors for 3. And I only use factors for 10, so those are automatic. I just have to check to make sure that I get my middle term. So my answer for this one is going to be 3x plus 5, x plus 2. This is what my answer looks like. Let's take a look at example 2. So again, I'm going to start with my two sets of parentheses. I call them boxes. It's kind of an easy way to, well, it's easier to say boxes than it is parentheses. So 12 has a whole bunch of stuff. So I can just take my choice. I'm going to say 3 and 4 to start with. So I have 3x and a 4x. And my last term is a 3. Only one way of factoring 3. Now, this right here is a really important. Avoid common factors in the box. If there is a common factor, we would take it out first, and there's no common factors between 12, 16, and 3. So we're not going to put the 3 in with my 3x. We're going to put it over with my 4x. And that means I'll put my 1 in with my 3x. Now, I'm going to check this. This says if my last term is negative, which is what I have here, we're going to subtract my outside from my inside. Okay, so that would give me 9x minus 4x, which would be 5x. Well, that's not going to work. Okay, now there's only was one way to get a 3, so I can't change my 1 and 3 because I can't put my 3 in there. So that means I'm going to have to change my 3 and 4. I can't change places because that gives me a common factor, which means I need to use a different factor. So we have 3 times 4, we use that. Let's try 2 and 6. If I put my 6 in with my 3, I get a common factor again. So we're going to put 2 in with my 3 and put my 6 in the other box. Okay, let's try this one now. Again, I have to keep in mind that I'm subtracting. I have 3 times 6 is 18 minus 1 times 2, which would be 2. So 18 minus 2 would give me 16x, which is what I want. I do want a positive. So here's a really cool trick to go with this. This sign, my outside sign, was always going to go in the last box, and my inside sign is always going to go in my first box. Really, really cool. Always wait until the end to put your signs in for these, because you never quite know where they're going to go. So my answer for this one is going to be 6x minus 1 and 2x plus 3. And we're done. And there's our answer.